Sweetie Pie, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do a video that I've actually been thinking about for a while now, and I obviously titled it Fairest of Them All. And it's just the best packaging I've seen in, I'd say like the last year and a half or so. Just pieces in my collection that I think are so beautiful. Today's edition is going to be about palettes. So I've got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I've got 8 palettes here that I just think are so beautiful, and the packaging just like blew me away, and I want to share them with you guys. So if you guys are interested, stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, obviously. It's just a thing, right? Like, it's a thing we do on YouTube. And like this video if you enjoyed it. Go to my Instagram. I do a look of the day every single day, and I'm not sure if it's going to be up before or after this video, but this eye look I did in honor of Nikki Tutorials. She lost her brother last week, and I'm so, so sorry. And anyway, this is supposed to be a happier video, so let's get on with that. And if that video is up, I will post it right there if you guys are interested in seeing it. Alright, let's get into this
video. So, the first palette we're going to talk about is one that I literally just got, and it is the Be A Light by Becca. Now, I did wash off the top because the problem with this packaging is that it does get fingerprints on it, but even when I'm showing you in the camera, it looks so pretty. They actually have, and it's very hard to see, but on this side there is a little circle, and it says, it doesn't say anything. It just has the Becca logo on it. And then the back, again, it shows you like how to use this palette. And then when you look inside, I love this setup. I think this is so pretty. The domed products, and oh my gosh, this blush is so shimmery. It looks so beautiful. And I will insert a picture, if I have one, of it brand new right here. It was just beautiful. And then it says, Take Chances, Becca, on the casing. So that is the very first one. Packaging, mwah. And I'm going to put corresponding videos up here because just because I love the packaging doesn't mean that I was diehard for all of the products in here. A lot of them I was, but there are a few in here that I wasn't like thrilled about. Second one here is the Too Faced Natural Face Palette. I think their new packaging is so beautiful. So you've got the front here, and it almost looks like a clutch, like a handbag that you would wear. And it has that beautiful like domed effect with the resin inside and then the lace around it. The back looks like this, very classy. And then when you open it, it was a paradise when it was brand new. It's still beautiful. And I think that once you buy something, you always see it as what it looks like, or what it looked like, brand new, at least in my eyes. It has Too Faced, a huge freaking mirror, and then these products. Everyone knows I freaking love these products. They are scented, and I'm not sure exactly what the scent is, but I think it's cinnamon. Yeah, like I think it's like a cinnamon cookie or something. I can't remember exactly what it's supposed to be, but I smell cinnamon cookie. Now, another brand that I wanted to mention, and I really don't want any flack because I know she has some drama going on right now. I don't want to tell you what my opinion is. If you want a video on that, you know, comment down below and I might do it. But chances are, I don't want to voice my opinion. I love this brand. I love this brand. And it is obviously Kat Von D. Packaging for Kat Von D is always immaculate. The one I just did a review on is the 10th anniversary palette. This is so beautiful. The artwork on the front is done by Kat. She does this artwork. She thinks up these concepts and she's so creative. Let's just talk about the makeup, people. Anyway, beautiful, beautiful colors in the palette. Huge mirror. My only gripe was that it kind of doesn't go down. But regardless, if you sat it in front of you, like, you could use it as a mirror. I don't want to hear it. Then the second palette from Kat Von D is the Pastel Goth. Such a pretty, like, drippy pattern. Like, come on, it's literally just paper and it looks so cool. Like, and then we also have the metal matte mini. I do not have the metal matte palette, but I did pick this one up. And it's so cool. Like, come on. Who thinks of this? And, like, I love the inside of her packaging always. I love Kat Von D's packaging. I love her products, period. And then the last Kat Von D palette I have that I love. I also have some of the minis. They're not quite as extravagant. This one is so beautiful. This is the Saint and Sinner palette, and I know that a lot of people didn't like this, but I have so grown even fonder of this palette paired with the 10th anniversary palette. It's beautiful. It's a match made in heaven. Anyways, so it's like cathedral. Really, the glass could be there or not for me. It's just the presentation, people. It's beautiful. I love this palette. I think this is such a cool palette. Ugh, I love Kat Von D, guys. I'm sorry. Anyways, the last two palettes I have in this collection of beautiful palettes, this is an older one. This one I'm actually selling on Kijiji Canada right now. I have, I think, 10 gently used products. We don't have Poshmark in Canada, so I have to use what we have. So what I have here is the Natural Love palette. This was one of my first high-end palettes, and honestly, there are so many beautiful neutrals in here. This is what the palette looks like. I just don't reach for this enough, and it's almost in new condition, and I feel terrible because it almost makes me not want to do it. Like, if no one ever calls me about that ad, I'll probably just keep all of them and say it's all good. But this is so beautiful. The, you know, like, it has this felt on it that did get a little bit dirty, but it was still so beautiful. I think they did a great job on the packaging on this. The birds and the leaves, I just. Anyway. After the packaging, the neutrals are beautiful. I have so many now that it's just a redundant thing in my collection. And the last little baby I want to talk about is the Naked Heat by Urban Decay. I think this is the best packaging they've ever brought out for a palette. Like, I don't think I have another Urban Decay. Like, I do have the Heavy Metal, which is a cool packaging, but this is so cool. It has, like, 3 inlays on it where it looks like it's moving. I'm sure you guys have seen this. This was a, you know, a pretty hot topic for a while. But yeah, I have no problem with any of the packaging I've showed you. Using it, all that good stuff, whatever. These colors, you're gonna get a lot of monochromatic looks. That is the truth. But I love them. I love the red tones. Like, honestly, I should have used some of them today for this look, but I actually used 5 other palettes. But yeah, guys, this is a beautiful palette. It's gorgeous. I think that the packaging was superb. The only thing is that obviously, as time went by, I have started to get scratches and scrapes on the surface of this. So, of course, with age, everything just gets some character. So yeah, guys, that was everything. That was all the palettes that I think are so beautiful. And most of these palettes I loved. A couple of them I was like, eh. So yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you really would want me to pick who is the fairest of them all, in this one, I think I would probably go with the Kat Von D 10th anniversary. This artwork really inspires me. I think it's so beautiful. She's got her signature in gold at the bottom. It's something special. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys subscribe to my channel. Do not leave any Kat Von D hate comments. Please. Just please don't. Everyone can do what they want. Within reason. And that is something that's not against the law. She won't be able to bring her kids to school. I'm sure she'll be homeschooling them, working it out. It's her decision. Anyway, guys, I hope you had a good video. I hope you have a good night, day, whatever. And yeah, bye. Mwah.